So here we've got a section of pipe with water entering on the right-hand side and leaving on the left-hand side. Let's say that it enters, we'll call this location 1, and it leaves at location 2. We've got a standard coordinate system as shown with x to the right, y going upward, and the z direction coming out of the screen. Let's call this velocity vector v1, and this velocity vector is v2. And let's decompose both velocity vectors into their x, y, and z components. So we'll say, for v1, we'll say it's u1 multiplied by I hat, so the x direction, plus lowercase v1 in the y direction, or j hat, plus w1, or the z direction, or k hat. Because this is a two-dimensional flow, W1 is going to be equal to 0. So there's no component of velocity in the z direction that's entering at location 1. And we can do something similar for V2. The first question we've got is, what are the signs of these components of the velocity? So U1, V1, U2, and V2. Let's start by decomposing V1 into its horizontal and vertical components. Well, the horizontal component will be acting to the left, and the vertical component will be acting downward. So this horizontal component is U1 I hat, and the vertical component is V1 J hat. So looking at it, we've got U1 is acting in the negative x direction, so U1 will be less than 0. V1 similarly is acting in the negative y direction, so V1 is also less than 0. And if we examine the velocity vector on the left, when we decompose that, we find that there is no horizontal component of velocity in that case. So here, u2 is equal to 0, and v2 is going to be in the positive y direction, or greater than 0. The second question we've got is asking, what are the signs of V1 dotted with the outward facing unit normal, N1, and the dot product between V2 and N2? Well, to answer this question, we first have to understand what a dot product is, and we have to understand what an outward facing unit normal represents. Well, to get at that, let's take a look at the details of this pipe. So we'll look at this right end here. And when we examine it, we'll look at the opening of it. We've got, remember, fluid is entering in this region. The velocity vectors everywhere flow into the pipe in this direction. So in the direction, of course, of the pipe. The control volume, when we draw that, the control volume comprises, let's say the control volume comprises the interior of the pipe. And the velocity vector and the outward facing unit normal are opposite in direction. So these unit normals here for this control volume all face directly outward from the surface of the pipe. If we go back to the original perspective, this means that the unit normal faces directly opposite to V1. So this would be N1. And if you recall the definition of a dot product, V1 dotted with N1 is equal to the magnitude of V1 multiplied by the magnitude of N1, multiplied by the cosine of the angle between those two vectors. In this case, we've got N1 acting to the upper right and V1 acting to the lower left. So the angle between those two, in this case, is equal to 180 degrees. And the cosine of 180 degrees is equal to negative 1. And because we're defining the magnitude of N1 is equal to 1, and the magnitude of the velocity, it must be positive. That means that V1 dotted with N1 has to be less than 0. In fact, V1 dot N1 is not only less than 0, it's actually equal to the negative value of the magnitude of V1. Well, let's look in more detail in the upper left of our pipe. So we zoom in here. We find that the velocity of the water is leaving uniformly throughout this section of the control volume. So that would be our velocity vector there. And the outward facing unit normal is also in that direction. So it's in exactly the same direction as the fluid leaving. Back to our original perspective, we've got the outward facing unit normal at that location, N2. So if we examine the dot product of V2 and N2. This, again, by definition, would be the magnitude of V2 multiplied by the magnitude of the outward-facing normal at 2 multiplied by the cosine of the angle between them. In this case, the vectors are pointing in the same direction, and the cosine, or that angle, is equal to 0. The cosine of 0 is equal to 1, and the magnitude of the outward-facing unit normal is also equal to 1. So in this case, V2 dot N2 is equal to the magnitude of the velocity leaving at location 2, which is a positive quantity.